Race 2 of Season 13 of the NASCAR Pomod Cup Series headed over to Pensacola National Speedway for the running of the UNHO Racers 555. Tristan Foulkes led the pole as the PCS went to this track last season, but it's the road course configuration. But this season we're heading to the true super speedway configuration where speeds are a lot faster and a lot more fun racing, as you see 3, 4, maybe even 5 wide packs are already starting to develop in this race. Jackie Tang would take the lead on the next lap after Tristan Foulkes led the first lap of the race. And there would be other hungry competitors such as the 31 Sean Hartful and the 30 Jordan Davis going down below, as you see they're battling for the lead. Dylan Young, the 33, the winner from Daytona, is also in the top 5 mix as they're now 4 wide for the lead. Man, this racing already on 2 laps already is way better than what the entire race last season in Pensacola was. It was a messy, messy road course race, but this weight race, we could expect to see some thrilling, thrilling action all day, all night, actually, because this had transitions. This is the only track where transitions actually work. It goes from sunset to the nighttime, which is pretty cool. I wish many other tracks would have this working as well. I know Homestead Miami had one working, but I couldn't get the real day-night configuration to work. This one I didn't even have to try to fix it. So anyway, the 33 Dylan Young would take the lead briefly, but only for a brief moment, as other competitors, leaving the 22 Jasmine Acosta going on the bottom battling for the lead, for the race lead. Jasmine Acosta would take it away in the 22, one of the final four finals from last season. But PJ Williams in the number 10 Tide car is trying to make a battle 3 wide, as you see 9 and 10 battle for second, and we got ourselves a big wreck already in the back. Is back a lot of drivers involved, a lot of spins, a lot of crashes. There you see Navarro and Chris Washer battling for the second position as Jasmine Acosta does an awesome job blocking the bottom line here at this track, as this track is very wide, a lot of moves can be made, and there is, well, the only thing that doesn't have room for is error. And you could see a lot of drivers involved in a big crash on the first caution. Acosta leads to the caution flag despite a hard charge from the 9 of Navarro. And whoa, Eric Powers, he just warped into that wall and goes for a wild ride as he was the worst victim of the incident. There you see Luke Walker, Dylan Young riding on the rails. Luke Walker gets spun. Mitchell Riggs involved. There you see the 8 machine of Tony Green, a rookie, as also went upside down. Here's Nathan Hudson's view as Hudson slid up. He got involved in the incident as well, along with many other drivers that were slipping and sliding as well. And boom, Benjamin in the 24, Nicholas Guerrera could not avoid the incident as well. Even the defending champion couldn't avoid an incident like this. Onboard camera with the 21 of Powers, he goes upside down, goes for a wild ride, and we have a restart. Drivers restarted in the order they had on the caution. I don't think they had pit stops during the caution period. It was only lap 4, so it's pretty early in the race for pit stops, in my opinion. Jasmine Acosta would take the lead in the 22, as you see Chris Washer going down 4 wide, trying to pick up where he left off. But Nick Alton in the number 40 machine would go down below, gets the preferred bottom line, and he would take the lead away from everybody else. Then coming up the 10 of PJ Williams and the 37 of Kate Culp. Kate Culp, one of the few female drivers, along with Jasmine Acosta, Leah Walker, racing this season. We don't really have a lot of female drivers as we had in seasons past, but they're still trying to show their worth in the Pomod Cup Series, that they can battle against the big boys. No female driver has ever won the Pomod Cup Championship. We'll see if Culp can change that, or even Acosta or Jasmine Acosta. They're the only two that can legitimately compete for the championship. But they need to win a race before the chase first in order to do that. But anyway, the 26 Johnny Gardner gets the lead away from the 40 on a side-by-side battle with him and alone. As he gets the lead away from the 40, Nick Alton. Nick Alton, I think, might be the same driver as Nick Altendorf. If that person's the same driver, let me know in the comments below. because I'm not really, I don't really know a lot about Nick Alton or Nick Altendorf, whatever. But anyway, here comes the 28 of Mason Powers. Mason Powers, a rookie this season. Not sure. The other Powers, Urich, wrecked out, as you saw, the worst of it. Mason trying to keep the Powers the Powers name alive. And going side by side, battling for the lead here at Pensacola. As Mason Powers gets the lead away. Zeke Marley in the 98. Battles for second, maybe even the lead, because this battle for second at this track can turn into a battle for the lead with the right drafting out from the right drivers. Anyway, a three-wide battle endures with Marley on the bottom. Marley gets the preferred line, and the 98 still trying to get the lead. It's tough to hang on to the lead at a track like this. There you see a side-by-side battle as we go three wide again. These guys have been going three, four wide for a while now, and they're still not giving up their own momentum. So that's pretty incredible. There you see the 99 of Pichu trying to take the lead away. But Pichu would have to come down pit road like everybody else. As you see drivers starting to slow down. Oh no! Pichu got hit by Benjamin Miles on his way down to pit road. Tough break for the 99. He was in contention for the win, and then Miles just spun him out. And Miles also clipped the 6 of Roman Rahal. Rahal was not going to go into pit road on that lap, but he got hit by Miles on the contact from Pichu. And Rahal's race would be over just like that. There you see the 98 continue to lead, but he would have to come to pit road along with many other drivers. Johnny Gardner would stay out to keep his lead over the 28 of Mason Powers, but these drivers would have to pit as well. And these guys started to come in a little early, earlier than most drivers did, as you saw earlier, and that was a big mistake. As they went down above the line, slowing up, and even the drivers that just came out of pit road were able to pass them during the period. It's unfortunate Gardner in the 28, Mason Powers. Powers and Gardner, a tough break for them. They went too committed too early. They had to scoop up high just to get enough speed. Now they have to slow down back to pit road. A tough break for those two drivers who are going to compete for the win. The number two, Deon Scott, would took the lead under that period, but he'd have to come to pit, and the pit stops would cycle out, and Chris Washer would retake the lead about everybody else. Kate Culp running second. Abby Sachs, we haven't talked about him all day, in third. And well, now from fourth to second, and to the lead is Zeke Marley. And here comes the 98 of Marley, trying to get the lead away from Chris Washer, side-by-side battle. Four drivers left in contention for the win. The drivers were separated by pit stops and all that kind of stuff. By the way, the Pichu incident, Rahal's incident, didn't cause a caution. We only had one caution throughout the entire race, which was very surprising considering this is a super speedway. A lot of racing, pack racing happens at this track, and I'm surprised there was only one caution in this entire race. But we still had some good races racing like this one. As you see, Abby Sachs goes for the lead against the 98. Zeke Marley. And here Sachs Sachs last season competed in a part-time role with Daniel Coffey during the World Course Tour. This season he's back in a full-time ride in the number one machine. He's the first one in number one, so he's hoping to win number one at Pensacola. Here comes rookie Kate Culp. Even though she's a rookie, Kate Culp is racing like a professional. As you see, she's battling for second. Lap car Benjamin Miles. It would hold up Sachs for just a brief second. But that was more than enough for Kate Culp to make her pass for the lead. And Chris Washer even took the second position away from Abby Sachs during the line. But Chris Washer had some tricks up his sleeve as he goes side by side with Kate Culp, and Chris Washer went on to take the lead away. Zeke Marley and Sachs trying to hang on. Oh boy, Culp tries to get, blocks the high side, still trying to make it work. I see a brief sun, as you see the sun, the sun went down and became night now, and I saw a little brief of day, by the way, but believe it or not, I saw a bit of cloudy day skies, which is pretty weird for a track like this. But Kate Culp had to come down pit road with just a few laps left. Chris Washer would take the lead during that period. There would still be three drivers competing for the win, still three drivers, but things would get a little bit interesting as you see that Marley and Sack decided to pit along with some of the other drivers. Washer decided to stay out for a little bit longer, hoping to conserve that enough fuel to get the win. Chris Washer's last victory was last season's Super Snack 500. It was his only victory of season 12. But now he's not going to get another one. As you see, he's going to have to wait until he gets another victory this season. He has to come down Pear Road. That would hand the lead over to Jackie Tang with just two laps to go. And he's battling. And Jackie Tang is battling with Stephen Poehler III for the win. Then we would come over to the white flag with one to go. They pass the lap car, as you saw earlier, and Jackie Tang and Pollard would battle it out for the victory. It would be a one-on-one battle on the final lap of the race. Tang looking for his first career Pomon Cup win. Pollard's looking to win for the first time, I think, since season three or four, I'm not sure. But Pollard's still trying to get that win, trying to find a line he can pass with Jackie Tang. Tang has been an experienced driver in NR Town 3, but has never won a PCS race. But he could do it on his second start. Here they come, coming off the final corner, and it looks like Poehler is not going to be able to challenge the rookie. Coming off the final corner, winning the UNHO Racers 555, Jackie Tang takes the checkered flag for his first career Pokemon Cup victory in just his second career Pokemon Cup Series start. So what a victory it is for Jackie Tang. He holds off pit strategy, worked it to perfection, and gets the win under the lights here at Pensacola Speedway. What a way to get your first career win at a track like this. There you see the rest of the field. I was able to save it like last time, well, I was able to get the field. And I was a little careful about that, just to get the rest of the field, trying to be a little slower, because last time things were happening so fast, I just skipped through it, all of it. So anyway, find your names on the left of your screen. Second winner this season of season 13. Will we have a third winner? Join us next race at Orlando, the Chase Sapphire 500.